Hey guys, I already have my eyebrows done and I primed with concealer. Here I have baby lips in coral. It's absolutely amazing for Maybelline. I'm gonna start with my 280 color palette. This is a third edition from BH Cosmetics with a flat fluffy brush. I'm gonna take a light lavender color and I'm just gonna apply that all over my lid. You want to pack the color on so that it stands out. Next, I'm going to use the same brush on the other side, and I'm going to take this deep, pretty purple, also from the same palette, and I'm going to apply that in the V of my eye. And here I'm starting to create the shadow, the smoky eye here. I'm also dragging it into the crease line just under and just on the crease. I'm going to take a smudging brush and I'm going to use a very deep purple from the same palette, and I'm going to put that in my inner V to create the smoky eye. Next, I'm going to take a blending brush and I'm going to go back in with that really pretty purple from the palette. And I'm just going to blend in with that deep purple that we put on just earlier. And just to make it blend more and make it more cohesive, I'm going to take another blending brush cleaned off. I'm going to put a chocolatey brown, sorry, on my crease and just above my crease. I'm going to blend that in and make sure your brush is clean. This is a different blending brush, but it's also from BH Cosmetics. You want to put that at the corner and into the half of your crease. Next, I'm going to take another blending brush. It's angled. I'm going to take the pointy side. I'm going to make sure it points downwards. I'm going to just start creating more shadows, going to add more warmth to my eye look, and this is going to be an all-over blending. And I'm also using the same chocolate. Here, I'm going to take another blending brush, also from BH Cosmetics, and I'm going to go in with my transition color. It's a very light brown. The key to this look is a lot of blending, so you have to kind of just blend in everything. Here, I'm blending the transition color with that chocolatey brown to make them more flowy in a way. Next, I'm going to take this flat brush and I'm just going to go back in with that pretty purple, and I'm just going to just layer it on top just to make sure it's nice and out there. Just making sure color wasn't lost. I'm going to go in with the same brush on the opposite side and take that first light lilac color and go back in with that. I'm gonna take this cream beige color with a very small flat brush, and I'm gonna put that on my brow bone as a highlight. This part does not have to be really clean because I'm gonna go in with that blending brush, with a clean blending brush, and just blend it into the transition color. Next, I'm gonna line with my gel liner from Maybelline in black. I'm gonna go back in with a really, really small flat brush, and I'm gonna just make sure the color wasn't lost again, just kind of being precise with it. I'm gonna take my Wet n Wild liquid liner and put it on top of that gel liner just to set it and just to make it look a little bit more sharp. Alright, here I'm going to take my Mary Kay medium coverage foundation with a stippling brush. It's a dual brush, and I'm just going to put that all around my face. Next, I'm going to contour my face with a small concealer brush, and I'm using Black Radiance in Ebony. I'm going to contour my T-zone, my Cupid's brow, my cheeks, and my chin. I'm going to blend this out with the same brush I used for my foundation. Now I'm going to contour. I'm using a dark eyeshadow. And it's totally fine to use products that are normally for other parts of your face, on other different parts of your face. For example, me using the eyeshadow as a contour powder. It's totally normal. And sometimes works better. Next, I'm going to use a Smooth Mineral Avon product as a blush. It's a really pretty light purple pink. And I'm just going to put the blush on the apples of my cheek, and I'm going to pull it up towards my hairline. And this also helps with the contour. I'm just going to put this all over with a little bit of product left. Here I'm going to take a lipstick, and I'm only going to put it in the middle of my lips. This is from Wet n Wild. It's a very light pink. I'll list it down below in the description box. I'm going to take a lip gloss type thing, and I'm going to just apply that, and that's going to act as the rest of my lip. And I'm going to blend it out with the lipstick I put on earlier. I'm going to use some mascara and just add some on my my eyelashes. And I'm just going to clean up my lipstick with a foundation brush, just so it looks cleaner. And that's it. So I'm just looking out my hair, looking pretty for you guys. If you like, please subscribe. And this is my second one. It's going to get better. Bye.